Our help is in the name of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Stir up your might, we pray you, O Lord, and come rescue us through your great strength, so that salvation, which has been hindered by our sins, may be hastened by the grace of your gentle mercy. We ask this through you who lives and reigns forever and ever. Good morning. On this fourth Sunday of Advent, let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord, bless us with the wisdom to praise you in spirit and in truth, so that by following your holy will, we may gain eternal salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment, confess our sins to God in ways that we have failed him and our neighbor in thought, word, deed, and omission, so that we may worthily participate in this holy sacrifice. Please now make an examination of your conscience. Let's say together the first form of the Confiteor on page 66. Almighty Father, you know my deepest secrets. I confess that I have, through my own fault, sinned against your holy laws. In my thoughts, in my words, and what I have done or failed to do, I sincerely regret my sins, and I am truly sorry for offending you. I ask, Father, that in your mercy, you pardon my sins. I promise to change my way of living so that through a deeper holiness, I may better serve you throughout the rest of my life. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. For your penance, I would ask you to say one Our Father and one Hail Mary. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you. And with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you filled your servant Elizabeth with your Holy Spirit as she greeted the mother of our Lord. Fill us now with your grace so that we too may rejoice in your salvation. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our first reading.
The first reading is from the book of the prophet Micah. Thus says the Lord, you Bethlehem Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore the Lord will give them up until the time when she who is to give birth has born. And the rest of his kindred shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God. And they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please respond, Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
O shepherd of Israel, hearken. From your throne upon cherubim, shine forth. Rouse your power, and come to save us.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted, the Son of Man, whom yourself has made strong.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
May your help be with the man of your right hand, with the Son of Man, whom you yourself made strong. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name.
Lord, make us turn to you. Let us see your face, and we shall be saved.
The second reading, a reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me. In holocausts and sin offerings, you took no delight. Then I said, as it is written in the scroll, behold, I come to do your will, O God." First he says, sacrifices and offerings, holocausts and sin offerings, you neither desired or delighted in. These are offered according to the law. Then he says, behold, I will come to do your will. He takes away the first to establish the second. By this will, we have been consecrated through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled. This is the gospel of the Lord. For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. These words are taken from today's gospel according to St. Luke, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, if you're anything like me, this time of year, especially right before Christmas, there's kind of a feeling of joy and expectation, as well as kind of a feeling of melancholy. And these two can coexist, because we're joy with the expectation of the celebration of the birth of our Lord, and maybe melancholy at the past joys that will no longer be in our lives. Well, that's no different now than it was 2,000 years ago, or will be in the future. But here we have in our gospel, Mary says she traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah. It doesn't say which town, but tradition tells us it's either in or around the current city of Hebron in the southern part of Israel. Now Hebron, walking, is about 8 hours and 15 minutes from Bethlehem and about 9.5 hours from Jerusalem. So Mary made quite the trek to see her cousin Elizabeth. And you gotta remember that Mary was probably about 6 months or so along at this point when she made the trek, which is very hilly. And she went because she wanted to be with family. 14-year-old girl, pregnant, traveling an 8 or 9 hour walk to visit her cousin. She wasn't yet living with Joseph, yet she wanted family, she wanted companionship. And she must have had that similar feeling of joyful expectation at the coming of her son, and perhaps some melancholy at knowing that her life was about to change forever. And yet she is the most blessed who ever walked this earth, because she was the vessel for our Savior. So we are in good company if we have mixed feelings around this time. But what does that mean for us? Well, it means that whenever we endeavor to follow Jesus, to follow God, and do what he asks of us, we're always going to be a little bit afraid. And a little bit sad, because we got to give up what perhaps we might want in order to do what he wants. However, what joy did Mary have that day she gave birth? What joy does any woman have when the day they give birth, or any parent? That joy far eclipses anything that came before it, right? That is the joy that we should have as Christians this week when we celebrate the birth of Jesus. Because it's our birth as well, our birth into the opportunity for eternal life. Sometimes expectation never meets reality. I remember I was about 8 years old, about 1980. One thing in the world I wanted most was an Atari. And I asked for it, and asked for it, and asked for it. And Christmas Day came, there was a box about that size under the tree. I was so excited. I opened that box. That box wasn't an Atari. I think it was the game of Operation. A little red nose that buzzes when you hit the side. There was another box that was much thinner, and that was the Sears knockoff version of Pong. Now, I was disappointed, but I actually ended up playing with that quite a bit, because it was what I had. But I came to realize that my parents did the best they could. I loved them for that. I never got an Atari. That's okay. I turned out all right, I think. But point is that sometimes when we anticipate something and don't get it, we're disappointed. Disappointment comes from our false expectations. Now, with Jesus and Christmas, our expectations will never exceed the reality of what happened. And that is the most beautiful thing about our life of faith, is that no matter what we expect to happen from following Jesus, from following God, and doing his will, the reality will always be greater than anything we can ever expect. That's the story of Advent. That is the story of our lives, which are basically an advent to our eternity. So let us be like Mary. Run to those around us, and our family, our friends, our faith family, and be there for each other in our sufferings, but even more so in our joy, so that we can together celebrate that joy of our salvation that came in the form of a little baby. For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us now stand and turn to page 71 and say together the creed that unites us as Christians. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Like the Virgin Mary, let us pray now, trusting that the Lord's promises to us will be fulfilled. And our Advent response is, Come, Lord Jesus, come.
for the church, that she may continue to be a beacon of hope, calling us to turn to the Lord for a new life. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
That the Lord may guide all who are working to provide resources, relief, and comfort to those affected by the tornadoes in the south. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
For parents, that they may be blessed with the courage and strength of Mary, who trusted God's divine plan. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
For our families, as Christmas draws near, that we may hold in our hearts the hope and wonder of the Christ child, who is God with us. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
For the sick, especially those on the prayer list and their caregivers, that the Lord may keep all under the shelter of his care. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
For our own needs and intentions. And for Sophia Concas, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come.
For all who have died and those who will die today, that they may share the gift and promise of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Lord Jesus, come. Almighty God, prepare our hearts with your grace so that, like Mary, we may be a worthy dwelling place for your Son. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. I see him, though not now. I behold him, though not near. A star shall advance from Jacob, and a staff shall rise from Israel. Blessed are you, Lord, give all creation to you, against us bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made, be it come for us, the bread of life. The mystery of this wine. And the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the divine work of human hands, may it become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, and bless the sacrifice which you have prepared for the glory of your holy name. Lord, wash away my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Receive this offering, most holy Trinity, which we make in memory of the Passion, Resurrection, and Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, and in honor of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints. May they, whose memory we honor on earth, intercede for us in heaven. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, you showed the world the splendor of your glory in the coming of your Son, born of the Virgin Mary. May we worthily offer this holy sacrifice and celebrate the mystery of God made man. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ our Lord. For through the promised sending of Jesus Christ to earth for us, you revealed your goodness and unending love. Sharing in the hope of patriarchs and prophets, may we worthily prepare a dwelling place for the coming Messiah in our hearts. Therefore, with the angels and archangels, with all the saints and the entire church, we lift our hymn of praise to your glory, repeating unceasingly, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy Sacrifice of the Mass will continue with Eucharistic Prayer 4, which is found on page 88. Blessed are you, Lord of all majesty and King of eternal glory, for your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. In him your word was made flesh. In him the fullness of your grace was revealed in splendor. In all things he fulfilled your will and glorified your name. He proclaimed your kingdom to us. He broke the power of darkness over us. He took our guilt upon himself. He reconciled us to you and unlocked the new paradise for us. As the way, the truth, and the life, he has revealed your love to us. He humbled himself and became obedient even to death on a cross, and by rising restored our life. On the night in which he was betrayed, to undergo that suffering which he himself had chosen, he took bread into his hands, and lifting his eyes to you, his heavenly Father, he gave thanks. He blessed the bread, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which is given for you." Supper had ended, he took the cup and gave thanks to you. He blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which shall be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you do this, do it in remembrance of me." Together, your death, Lord Jesus, we proclaim, your resurrection we celebrate, your return in glory we await. Therefore, Father, we remember his saving passion, his glorious resurrection, and his exaltation at your right hand. We await his coming in the fullness of majesty. We here set forth this sign of our faith in him, who offered you the perfect sacrifice and gained for us eternal salvation. Send your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and holiness, upon us, and upon these gifts, the bread and wine of eternal life. Together, Holy Spirit, come to us, fill us with your gift of grace. Take these gifts from our hands, Lord God, as an acceptable sacrifice, through which we offer ourselves to you, so that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be a sharing in the body and blood of your Son. May all who receive from your heavenly altar always remain united with you, together with all your saints and chosen ones, with the blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of our Lord, with Saint Nemesius and companions whose memory we keep today, with your prophets and apostles, with your martyrs and confessors, and with all who stand about your throne in praise and prayer. Grant also, Lord, a share in that glory to the departed and to those whom we remember before you, especially Sophia, whose memory we keep today. Deal with them and with all people according to your merciful kindness, and let perpetual light shine upon them. Remember also your servants on earth for whom we invoke your mercy, especially all of those here and who cannot be with us today. Bless your church throughout the world, grant it unity and peace, renew the earth according to your promise. Remember all peoples and grant that all nations may give you thanks, worshiping and praising your holy name. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Let us pray, instructed by our Savior's teaching and following divine example, we say with confidence, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. The cup of blessing, which we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread, which we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ?
Because there is one bread, we who are many are one body, we all partake of one bread.
May the union of divinity and humanity in Jesus Christ bring us sanctification and eternal life.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Do not look at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Let's say together the First Communion prayer on page 97. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free me from all my sins and from every evil. Be me faithful to your teaching and never let me be parted from you. I will take the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring me to everlasting life. May the blood of Christ bring me to everlasting life. Those who are joining us online and those who cannot receive for personal reasons, please join me now in the act of spiritual communion. Most loving Jesus, I adore you in the most blessed sacrament in which you are truly present. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart and heal my soul. I embrace you and unite myself with you. May I never be separated from you. Inflame my heart with the fire of your love, my Lord and Savior. Amen. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord.
Thank you.
pure heart love that I take this food, may the gift I receive from healing strength now forever. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you this sign. The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. Let us pray. O God, most gracious Father, the mystery of your eternal word took flesh on earth when the Virgin Mary placed her life in your service. Through this Eucharist, may we receive the Spirit to help us prepare for his coming of truth, faith, and love. We ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please join me now in the prayer of St. Michael. Holy Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do you, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Please join me now in a prayer for peace with the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, thank you for joining us for Mass today. Pray that you have a wonderful day and week. Take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and come back for at least one of the Christmas Masses. And have a beautiful day.